I originally wasn't gonna do this on film, but I figured I would. I bought some Polaroid film, and I was gonna go through the step-by-step instructions of how to use it. They're really, this is the new stuff made by the Impossible Project, and I was kind of gonna go a step-by-step of how to do it. And this is the first time I've ever done it, so you're gonna learn it just like I learned it. But I've read the instructions on their website, so I'm gonna open this up. Well, they got a bobcat running back there, so don't mind the noise. And we'll see if we can do it. Now, there's very specific instructions on how to use this film. You can't let the film be exposed to direct sunlight, especially right when it comes out of the camera. So I'm going to try and do it like they instructed on the website. And I'll show you how to do that. That's not exactly what I wanted to happen, but... can't get the package open. I kind of wanted to make this thing uncut. Okay, there's a dark slide in here that's going to pop out when I feed this in my camera. Now, I got my 635 Polaroid. Now, I actually have two of these. I got a 662. I decided to use this one because I think it responds a little better when I push the button. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to feed this in here. And it's going to pop out that dark slide. Now, I'm going to tape this dark slide to the cover like they instructed on their website. So, and what's nice is it was a little overcast, so it's a little sunny now. So hopefully we should get a nice picture with some nice high contrast. I got my Challenger behind me, and that guy is red, so we'll get some nice solid contrast. What I'm doing is I'm taping. I got the tape. I'm going to tape this to the top of the camera. So when this picture comes out, it's going to be covered from the sun. And I'm gonna cover it with this shirt and put it in my pocket as soon as I take this picture. So I'm just gonna go set my frame up, and I guess we'll figure out how it goes. Okay, now I got a picture sitting here covered by this dark slide. And I'm gonna take it, turn it upside down on the concrete. I'm gonna cover it with the shirt to keep it warm. Now, I think part of it might have got flashed by the sun, so we'll see how the top of the picture turns out. You're supposed to let it set for 4 minutes, so I'm gonna pause the camera and we'll see how it develops. I think I might have ruined the top of that, because when I went to take the picture off, it kind of peeled the dark slide back and some of it exposed to the sun, so we'll see. Okay, I got my first picture down, and it's developing. You know, they say it can take up to 24 hours before the picture fully cures, but I'll post some videos of it, and I'm gonna take a second one too when I get back to the house. So I'm gonna take a second one right now, and just to have a good two sample size, and I'll show you the results. Well, I actually ended up taking three pictures because I exposed the top half of the second picture again when I went to remove it from the camera. So they say the first few seconds is really critical, so I went ahead and took a third picture and actually put it underneath the shirt before I detached it from the camera, so hopefully it won't get any sunlight, and we'll see how that affects it. They say when it gets exposed to sunlight, it'll be too light when it gets exposed. So I'm gonna go ahead and hang out here for a few minutes, and then I'll go back to the house and we'll do some follow-up stuff to show you the results. I just wanted to do a summary while I had some nice daylight. Here's the first picture I took. Looks like I didn't mess up the top border after all. Look, actually looks pretty good. Here's the second picture I took.
doesn't look any different. I held the car a little higher in the frame, and it looks pretty good. You know, I don't know if you can see that grain. We'll have to see how it comes out when I develop this footage, but picture's grainy, but they look good. I mean, you know, for a Polaroid. And then here's the third one. I tore the top of it a little bit when I taking the tape off of it, but it looked pretty good. So I'm gonna put this together, and I might actually take one of these and send it into that Impossible Project website